I'm Greg Grunberg, and I'm on the road to capture the stories of amazing families living with rare epilepsy. These are stories of love, perseverance, and hope. Today, my son is living well with epilepsy, but I know firsthand what it's like to be a caregiver to a child with a rare seizure disorder. These families have been through the unthinkable, and they're here to talk about it, laugh about it, hug about it. And I'm here to take care of them. This is The Caregiver. My guest today is Gloria, who is a caregiver for her daughter Grace, along with her husband Ascension, and older daughter Madeline. Grace, a gorgeous little girl with a big smile, has a rare form of epilepsy called Dravet syndrome, and her mom Gloria has a case of not taking time for herself.
Hi,
Gloria.
Oh my God, it's so nice to
so
see you.
So nice to see you too.
Hi.
Thank you for having me here.
I'm so glad you're here.
I can't wait to meet your family.
Come on in.
Okay.
Welcome.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Grace.
This is my husband, Ascension, and
hey,
this is Madeline.
So nice to meet you.
Hello.
Hi. Hi, Grace.
Come and shake hands, Grace.
Hi.
Thank you.
Wait a minute. Were we just about to bake a cookie or something? Can we bake something?
Yeah.
Oh, I want to bake something. Wow. Can I sit here and bake with you?
Want to bake?
Wow.
Where's the eggs?
Thank you
Thank
for letting
you.
Me just barge in here and have some fun. So take me through the family.
Well, my husband, who is my rock and my total support system, been married for 22 years.
Wow.
I can't even explain how much he's changed my life. He's the best part of us.
My wife's name is Elizabeth, and she's the queen of the
house. Of course she is.
So there you go.
Well, in our house, it's Gracie. Gracie's the queen. She runs the joint. We just live here, live on her timeline.
Okay.
And then we have Maddy. Maddy's the sweetest, kindest kid. Ascension will eat all the snacks in the house and blame it on the girls.
Perfect. I love it.
Poor Gracie can't defend herself. She can't say.
Right.
So he'll say it's her fault, but she can't open the bag.
Right, exactly. How did this
Maddy
happen?
Helped her.
Yeah, of course.
Right. They're partners in crime.
Yep. Tell me about you. Like, what do you like?
I dream of traveling.
Yeah.
I know it's really hard to be able to plan anything when you have a child like Grace, but, you know, it doesn't hurt to dream.
Right.
It doesn't hurt to hope and wish. I hope before I leave this earth, I will be able to go to England.
So who do you call, you know, when things get tough? Do you have friends that are really supportive as well?
I'm so lucky that I am very close with several other Dravet moms.
Mm-hmm.
And we reach out to each other, bounce things off of each other. We support each other. We're not in the same state, but we're just a text away, a phone call away.
It's not often that we kind of reflect on how we're doing, because this is a job, right? Being married, being a mom. So how would you describe yourself as a mom?
For me, that is a very hard question to answer, because what is a mother? Mm-hmm. You know, a mother just tries her best every day. I have to try harder most days than others for Gracie.
Yeah.
In the beginning, I didn't know what I was doing. Everything that I did learn about being a mother, I'd throw out the window and start all over. But luckily, I have Ascension. So,
right.
You know, we have to figure out what makes every day work for us. And it's a team effort.
And then also Maddy, as an older sister, growing up faster than she probably would want to at certain times, because you're just dealing with stuff that you normally
So many times in the middle of the night, we had to wake her up and say, we have to take your sister to the hospital. We'll be back for you.
Yeah.
Get a bag ready. And I've never shielded a seizure from Maddy. Maddy was 10 years old and she was included in everything, because this is a team.
Yeah.
We all have a role to play. Maddy knows what to do in an emergency. Maddy knows how to take care of a seizure. Mm-hmm. And I'm proud of that. I'm proud of her.
So I'm looking around. Not only do you have flowers and paintings of plants in the house, but you have a nice garden.
Thank you.
What is it about
plants
that you're attracted to?
Well, I'm a novice gardener. I'm just started. Mm-hmm. And I wanted to have an outlet when things aren't going so great with Grace.
Yeah.
So there have been times when I've been out there digging and crying at the same time. Because, you know, just thinking about Grace and what did I do? What is coming down the road? So I get a lot of emotion out when I'm out there sweating.
So I think we can both admit that we're really good caregivers. We try our best.
Try to be.
Right.
Right.
We both deserve just a fun day. And I want to learn more about you, more about your husband, more about your beautiful family, but I want to do it in a different setting. Would you mind if I take you somewhere that I think you're really going to love? And we'll just, it's a surprise, but it's a really great surprise.
Okay.
Let's do it.
I'm excited.
You're excited? I'm excited.
Yes, I can't wait.
All right.
Okay.
Well, my car's right here.
All right.
I see a smile. It makes me so happy that Gloria is coming with me for this day of care and that she can lean on her family to take care of Grace. Meet me on the next episode of The Caregiver to find out just what I have planned for this plant lover.